So, good evening, guys. This is going to be a very quick video describing tomorrow's potentially dangerous situation here across the mid-Mississippi River Valley, and particularly in central and southern Iowa, northern Missouri, and west central Illinois is the main re are the main regions I'm looking at tomorrow. Doing this video, it's quicker to describe what's going on rather than typing that, and I will have a detailed discussion at some point, sometime tomorrow morning after the new runs come out early in the morning. I have to wake up very early. It's 10 o'clock. I have to be up at 3 or 4 in the morning. So stay tuned to that. So this is just a very quick rundown of tomorrow. So generally, sometime in the mid to late afternoon, we will have supercells develop somewhere in this region, mid to late afternoon tomorrow. A couple factors, mainly when is the cap going to be broken when from the rain that comes through Iowa in the morning? When is that cap, that stabilizing air, the temperature inversion, where temperature actually increases with height because of that rain stabilizing the air? When is that going to be broken? In the afternoon, that is the main key for those storms to grow and for storms to form in general. That's the main question right now, and where is that going to happen? So that's the main area that I'm looking at for those questions. When is that going to happen is when the supercells will develop, and later on they will congeal and probably form more of a line. Not sure if it's going to be this far north, but generally in here would be more of a hail and damaging wind threat, definitely more of just a damaging wind threat there in south. But anyways, this is the area, these are the areas that I'm looking at tomorrow for some interesting weather anyways. So I'll show you guys a little bit more here. So I'll just keep that up just to show you guys. Hold on. Just to show you guys what I'm talking about with the HRRR and then with the NAM. This is the line will continue on over here's the NAM. And then this will see these form a little different and a little later than the other one, but generally the same exact area that we're looking at for both models here. This is more robust, but this is what I mean by the cap. This is set from the morning rainfall, very, very strong temperature inversion there, which is making the air very stable at the mid to lower, definitely more lower level, so that rising air cannot rise as quickly and form thunderstorms. Obviously, this is in the morning, but it depends on how quickly this cap breaks when that temperature inversion goes away, so the storms can form and grow in a heartbeat. And as you guys can see, as soon as this cap breaks, this is exactly where it was before. We have very strong cape here. This is the area between the temperature and the air partial here. Parcel here, and then the hodograph showing very strong, strong to very strong wind shear. So that these massive and robust supercells to develop early on here, but the NAM differs because this early morning convection here, this convection here that stabilizes that air, comes in just a tad later, but makes that much of a difference. And that makes storms fire later because since the cap is in place, put in place later because of the rain, that means storms won't form until later. So that definitely has an effect of what's going to happen tomorrow and where and when, for sure. So anyways, so this is kind of what I'm looking at tomorrow for a risk area. It's kind of sloppy. But like I said, these storms will form along this warm front here in Iowa on the southwestern edge of this convection that will develop late morning. And they will be tapping into this very unstable environment, very favorable wind shear right on the cusp of that warm front. And I'll show you guys that real quick since you guys get an idea of the risk area for the worst severe weather tomorrow. Now, as you guys can tell, this is at 4 o'clock tomorrow, but I kind of drew in where that warm front line is. You can definitely tell the temperature differences in 90s here, but we have. Well, especially up here where the convection is in the 60s, but high is only really reaching in the 80s in central Illinois, maybe 80, 83 here at 4 o'clock tomorrow. But just on the other side of that, we got 80s and 90s. So you can tell the air is very, very warm and moist here. But definitely stay tuned. For the moment, this area is very heightened tomorrow. But yeah, definitely stay tuned and see what happens. I'll have more stuff up in the morning. Thanks for watching.